Here we go, this is the playthrough of Killzone 3. Feels pretty odd doing such a recent playthrough, because I'm so used to doing playthroughs of games that are pretty fairly old. But this one is only like 2 months old now. We're actually gonna watch through the intro and then we'll begin the campaign. And I'm gonna do it on veteran difficulty. Just because I did on veteran difficulty in Killzone 2, I feel like it's only right to do it, continue with difficulty. I actually haven't played Killzone 3 on the lower difficulties, normal or easy, but at the end of the first extrasolar war, Earth ISA forces had crushed the rule colony of Helghast. The victory did not bring peace, but instead brought humiliation, hardships, and bitter resentment. Driven by the vision of Scholar Bisari, the population of Helghast transformed from a defeated nation to a military superpower. They would become humanity's greatest threat. They call themselves the Helghast. Provoked into war, the neighboring planet of Begta launched an invasion fleet to deal with Bisari. Within seconds of entering Helghast's atmosphere, ground-to-space defenses ripped the fleet apart. Uncountable lives were lost due to the whatever. But against all hope, a small elite unit managed to fight their way into the heart of Helghast Nation, Bisari's palace. With the ISA forces on his doorstep, Bisari resorted to extreme measures. The nuclear devastation of his own capital, Pyre City.
My Archon, all preparations have been made.
Where are Radek and staff?
The package is ready.
Whoa, that really looks like Radek.
Father.
I guess they found a Radek lookalike, a Radek replacement.
My people, sons and daughters of Helghast.
Sorry's back.
On this day, as our enemy ships burn away in orbit, as our bodies lie broken in our streets, we are once again reminded of the depths of their
combat. Although, to be a Radek replacement, he's going to need super ninja training.
Unbearable hardships, banished by our enemies to die.
Teleport like crazy.
From famine, they scarred us, they weakened us, but that time has passed.
I don't know if these paintings and these burnings are supposed to have some kind of symbolic meaning.
And our nation. But that time
has
passed.
Wow.
All these years,
it really looks like a star in this Russia up here.
From this day till the end of days.
You have to move the ISA out here.
That's the intro of Killzone 3. I found the intro of Killzone 3 severely disappointing, especially compared to the amazing introductions of Killzone 1 and Killzone 2. Killzone 3 is just weird. Like, it introduces Bisari and a dream that Seb has, but for what? For that kind of sequence? No thanks. It's not even that great. It doesn't even doesn't really take advantage of the graphical quality of Killzone 3, which I guess the engine is a little bit improved from Killzone 2. So, I don't understand. Anyway, we're gonna do a new campaign, and as you can see, I've actually beaten Killzone 3 in Elite difficulty. God, it was a bitch, but it was a lot easier than Killzone 2. Overall, this game is so much easier than Killzone 2, but I'll get over that. I'll explain that in detail. The orchestral soundtrack comes back in full force in Killzone 3, and it's pretty fantastic. I really love the introduction with the string orchestra. It kind of has a sad feeling to it, and I guess it tries to invoke the feeling of desperation and loneliness, and the music definitely does that. The campaign itself, though, especially compared to the previous prequel, leaves a lot to be desired, especially in the storytelling. They really tried to amp up the pacing by making it more action-packed and stuff, but in either way.
6 months ago, our enemies murdered a great man. Scholar Bisari,
wow.
Our nation's father.
Look at
today,
that.
We
so
remember
many.
The hook he gave up.
This is a general, I forgot his name, but I feel it, they really made the general look like Joseph Stalin or something.
Jeez.
tell our children of this day, the day his misery became.
Although his speech, move, hand gestures are like reminiscent of Hitler. Stahl Arms Deep South Facility. Ooh, in the snow. Let's see. Oh, whoa. Wow, I started as a Helghast, huh? I always wanted to play at the side of the Helghast. Great way to start out the game.
You know the drill. Reporting.
There's a lot more color to this game. This game just throws colors at you like ridiculousness. Gotta check the front desk.
August 2. You've been assigned to weapons testing.
That's a nice gun. That's the M224 weapons
all
testing.
Right. Prisoner transport incoming.
Looks like the Helghast got some prisoners. Yep.
Go on through.
Way on through.
You're all being paid to stand around watching. Get to your post.
So I just follow this guy. Their helmet looks a little bit different than in Killzone 2. It's a little bit more square, not rounded. And this snow uniform is new also.
What are you doing?
Because of the, I'm looking at you is what I'm doing. I'm checking you out.
Security is everyone's responsibility.
Checking you out. You have a fine Helghast body
there,
baby.
Is there something you want?
Yo. Yeah, see, this is more like it, the rounded helmet right here.
Wait. They're taking him to the broadcast room now, sir. Yes, sir. You two on lab duty. Go report for weapons testing.
Weapons testing, huh? Wow. Okay, so this is the weapon area. Check this area out. This is pretty cool. It's so bright. Jeez. Dark blue. It's nice though. I didn't know the Helghast helmet had all this, like, HUD and, like, I don't know. I didn't know it had, like, this information that you can look into. It's pretty interesting. Going down.
The armorer wants to see you. Far into the weapons range.
Okay, down we go. This is the weapons range.
Anyone working in sensitive areas of the facility needs clearance from me.
I barely turned my head in this room. So the new thing about Killzone 3 is the freaking ammo depots that you can supply it with. There's
destroy the targets in the center of the range.
Wow, I'm just shooting innocent civilians with their hands up. Notice that is totally the Helghast style, I guess.
Now it's time for Scion training.
Scion
take
training.
The pistol on the counter.
It's the Helghast pistol. It's
destroy the close targets in the range.
Guy with the gun, oh my god.
That's the wrong target.
That's the wrong target. Holy shit, so I'm supposed to shoot the innocent guy with the this is hilarious. I'm supposed to shoot the ISA with their hands up. Unarmed. That's pretty ridiculous. Wow, only the Helghast would have some kind of, that kind of training.
Alright, now switch back to your rifle.
Okay.
Try shooting those far targets in the range.
Yeah, I'm so tempted to shoot at the guy.
You see, target was hard to hit from far away.
Getting
so your weapon to zoom in on targets for a more accurate shot.
I already know how to play the game. Come on. I was actually I played some of Killzone 3 co-op with my friend, and he's really not into video games at all, and he had a really hard time with this part, just the introduction, like learning how to shoot.
When you're scattered targets, don't shoot back, but the ISA will. Ducking behind cover will keep you alive a lot longer.
But
use that metal plate.
And we played on very easy, actually.
Peek up to see
your
targets while in cover. Give it a try.
Very easy, it's ridiculous.
Try shooting while you peek from cover. That's the wrong target.
That's the wrong target.
These static targets don't shoot back, but the ISA will. Ducking behind cover will keep you alive.
Okay, I know. Just show me
your
target.
Use the metal plate for cover. You can peek up to see your targets while in cover.
Show me your target already, damn it. Show me your target.
These static targets don't shoot back, but the ISA will.
Oh.
Ducking behind cover will keep
By
you
shooting
alive
at him,
a lot
just
longer. Use that metal plate for cover.
He looked.
You can peek up to see your targets while in cover.
I'm not gonna shoot
right now. Try shooting while you peek from cover.
Okay. Here's a light target. There, I shot an innocent man, unarmed. I shot my target.
Sight your weapon while peeking from cover to shoot that far target.
I already did all that too. Okay, so there's the innocent man right there. I think that's it.
Alright, you know what you're doing. Yep, yeah, base clear.
Alright. That's the most basic training I've ever seen. Alright, here we go.
Hey, give me a hand with this. Okay, good.
Let's go. Try it out.
Just keep going. Wow. So this is what a Helghast weapons facility looks like. Stuff down there. So graphically, Killzone 3 is pretty damn amazing. There's definitely hardly any bad thing to say about the graphics of Killzone 3. Other than, I just kind of miss the greedy atmosphere, but that's just because I actually am one of the, I guess, few people who like the grays and the browns and the reds saturation of Killzone 2. It had its own, you know, dark art style, you know, and Killzone 3, it ups the graphical fidelity, but the thing I think is it's kind of lost its own really unique identity in the process. I mean, that's my opinion. I mean, it's still a Killzone universe. It's still the same kind of architecture, same kind of Helghast technology that you'll see, very kind of rusty. And kind of really old-fashioned, but at the same time, pretty futuristic and sci-fi looking. So it kind of keeps up the same atmosphere, same Killzone vibe to it. But by losing that grittiness, I think it really... It just kind of, at certain, sometimes, it feels like a different game. It's still Killzone, but, you know, I don't know. That's my opinion. So that's the introduction sequence. Wow, so immediately from weapons training to execution, huh? Helghast really trained their soldiers quickly.
I know what this nation means. And I will cut out this disease of compliance and subjugation. So, to honor the Tsari, tomorrow we launch the greatest military campaign in our history. Celebrate that. I will give you justice.
Who is this guy?
Revenge!
Is he like Bisari's replacement?
And the death
or successor?
Of his
Oh crap. They captured Captain Marvel. They're gonna execute him. Oh.
What?
Yeah. I knew we weren't playing the side of Helghast. 6 months earlier, Isari's palace. So this is right after Rico martyred Isari, because he just couldn't keep his finger up the trigger. Because Rico is such a dumbass.
Sir, you okay?
No, Rico. I'm not okay. We had the guy. We had him. And you killed him. You killed Isari!
Yes, sir. Cross the river.
Clear.
Can do. Absolutely. Of course, General. Tell me he's doing better than he looks.
I'm calling it. Time of death, 21:20.
Oh, this is just perfect. Just goddamn perfect. Truth, listen up. We are mobile and fine, so pack up your shit. Delta, you know the drill. Hooper, Wheels, ASAP. Where the hell are Velasquez and Sevchenko?
Right out the front door.
Look, Sam. I just did what
talking on the front steps.
I will damn well make sure he gets court-martialed 6 ways to Sunday for it.
Captain.
Corporal Sevchenko. Sergeant Velasquez. The man's pulling the plug. They want us to execute an emergency exit scenario. We're pulling every soldier off this planet.
We're retreating? I ain't leaving. This war isn't even half finished. What is this bullshit?
Oh, no. This is not how this is going to go down, you insubordinate son of a bitch. I should just fast-track that court-martial and have both of you shot. Now, you shut your trap. And you listen to me. Is that understood? Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Sergeant Velasquez.
What is this, Jarhead?
Are you stupid to follow a direct order to shut the fuck up,
Captain?
Okay, listen up.
Rico definitely should be court-martialed, though. I agree with that.
Intel has an advanced Helghast cruiser fleet zeroing in on our position. The general wants
after screwing up that badly, I don't think he should continue.
The best chance we have is to cut through the Masari district, across the Corinth River. From there, it's due east to the extraction point, which is a crater the size of Kansas somewhere underneath that mushroom
pod. Oof.
We've got one shot.
By the way, in Killzone 2, this section right here was all in red and like very foreboding, but now it's all like
nice job,
there's a sunlight and it's kind of just bright.
But there are best bet against whatever the Higgs are gonna put in our way.
There's no red color saturation, which I don't understand.
What the hell is that?
And there should be just I don't know, there should be a lot of Helghast body on the floor because I killed a hell of a lot of them trying to get here. Jeez, Helghast are full of surprises.
Now. Seth, I need you to come to the safe corridor! Move, move, move!
Rico and Seth are arguing about retreating, but pick an A. Just retreating is going to be hard enough, let alone fighting a war against the Helghast. Oh my god. That was a good rocket hit by the Helghast right there. Wow, the game literally starts with the Michael Bay moment.
Where the hell did that come from?
Really? And so this really sets the tone of the sequel, Killzone 3. Every cutscene pretty much has these kind of ridiculous action sequences. And it tries to be a little comedic, too.
Hell yeah.
I like Rico's hell yeah. Do I get to play yet? I'm dead. Game over. Thank you for playing Killzone 3.
Sam, you okay?
Yeah.
No, I'm not okay. Of course he's okay.
Anybody else?
He has Wolverine powers. He can regenerate from being riddled with bullets. These two guys took on waves and waves of Helghast and killed Radek and survived. So, yeah, he's pretty okay.